my apostolate, all of them, they are involved in satanic things. Every sculpture, every demonic object is a spiritual covering, demons that follow it. Keeping a cursed object can make God to strike you. What are the sculptures that are in there? What is their history? Where did they come from? Do you know where they were made and for what? Well, some of them can have demons inside that are controlling your poverty. We are casting out demons, and then some people get shocked, those demons coming back again, because you have got their object. Don't allow your children to watch magic things, to watch magic cartoons, or to play magic games. There are demons that are inside those things, and they attract serious attacks on your family. Some Christians, they love to watch horror. And after they watch it, they start to lock everything, including cupboards and everything, before they sleep. Why were you watching things that put fear? Even a small sound. Because those horror films are being designed by Satanists so that they transmit fear. Even to venture into big business, that is, man, you'll be afraid. So today I want to touch about demonic objects, and we are a deliverance house, and we need to know some of these things, how they affect our lives. Let's go to Joshua 7 verse 14. Joshua 7 verse 14. In the morning, therefore, because you see, the children of Israel were about to enter the land of Canaan. But before that, they were supposed to attack Jericho. After attacking Jericho, they were supposed to attack a small nation called Ai, A-I, a small nation with even two letters in its name. It had very few people, less than 300,000 people. So even Israel sent a small army to Ai. But to their surprise, because they were saying it's a small nation, to their surprise, they were defeated by a small nation. You can be defeated by the smallest demons. And you wonder, I'm fasting, I'm praying, I'm doing everything. Why is it I have been defeated by a small demon, a small country like I, with just two letters, A-I, defeated them? And Joshua prayed unto God and said, God, you must speak in the midst of the congregation of Israel and tell us, what is the problem? Why were we defeated by a small nation? So now we read verse 14. God is giving them a solution. In the morning, therefore, he's speaking to Joshua, you shall be brought according to your tribes. Bring people according to their tribes, and it shall be that the tribe which the Lord takes shall come according to families, and the family which the Lord takes shall come by households, and the households which the Lord takes shall come man by man. It's a selection process until I show you who is the problem or where is the problem. Then it shall be that he who is taken with the accursed things or accursed objects or objects that are cursed shall be burned with fire, he and all that he has, because he has transgressed the covenant of the Lord, and because he has done a disgraceful thing in Israel. So keeping a cursed object, a demonic object, you are transgressing against the covenant of the Lord, and you become a disgrace in the presence of the Lord. So we understand that there was one man who was found with an accursed object, and his name was called Achan.
Achan.
Now verse 25, when Achan was found with the accursed things, the Bible says, Joshua said, why have you troubled us? And the Lord will trouble you this day. And all Israel stoned him with the stones, and they burned them with fire after they had stoned them with the stones. So they burned his family, burned all the objects that this man had taken. So whenever you are keeping objects like this, God is showing us it is a disgrace to him. May the Lord bless the reading of his word today. Hallelujah. All right, let's go to Deuteronomy 7, verse 4 to 7. Deuteronomy 7, verse 4 to 7. Deuteronomy 7, verse 4 to 7. For they will turn your sons away from me and serve other gods, other idols or gods. It's also demonic objects. So the anger of the Lord will be aroused against you and destroy you suddenly, worshipping and serving other gods or other or objects can make God to strike you spiritually. But thus you shall deal with them. You shall destroy their altars. You break down their sacred pillars and cut down the wooden images and burn the carved images with fire. For you are a holy people to the Lord your God. The Lord your God has chosen you to be a people for himself, a special treasure above all the peoples on the face of the earth. So God is saying, when you have got certain dedicated carven images or sculptures that are demonic, you have to be, you must surrender them to the church so that they may be burned by a man of God. Because you are a holy nation, the Lord did not set his love on those or chose, because you were men more in number than any other, for you were a list of all the peoples. So you are chosen, you are special people of God. So you cannot stay with those objects in your family. Can you go back to that verse which says they must be burned, the carven images? But thus you shall deal with them, destroy their altars, break down their sacred pillars, cut down the wooden images, burn the carved images with fire. One day in Mabvuku there, I remember I was called sometime. There is a man that I was praying for. He had a wound on his leg, and that wound was not healing. Hello? It was not healing. I asked God, why is it I pray for this wound, but there is no healing happening? The Holy Spirit said, go to his house. I went to his house, and when I arrived there, I entered his lounge. As I was praying, I saw a sculpture of an old man that was there. It had white hair, looking at me in his lounge. A sculpture. It's just a nice sculpture when you look at it, of an old man, maybe in their tradition. But when I looked at it, I saw someone inside that sculpture. A young boy who changed to be an old man. And when I looked at it, I saw tears coming on that thing in the spirit, and it was darkening so that it could not see me eye to eye. So I said, Mama, do you want your husband to be healed? He said, can I destroy that sculpture there that is in your house? How did you get it? Who did it? He said, no, there is a certain traditional man somewhere in our area who sells them. He had a dream. You know, some of them, they don't just make those sculptures. They dream. Some of them even are traditional healers inside. And there will be stories. They are sent into the bush in a dream, and they are shown how to make that image, and they can sell it. So don't just buy sculptures without knowing. All those sculptures have stories behind. Ask them. They will tell you, this one is a mermaid, and it is what? This one is what? That snake, what they do? They call it found in Kariba. Manyami nyami. Nyami nyami, and whatever. And it's a story that they will tell you. So I said, Mama, let's burn this thing. And I want to destroy it because it has demons. Your husband's wound is connected to this sculpture. The woman was shivering. Said, no, not my sculpture, prophet. No. Ooh, my sculpture. I said, Mama, there is your deliverance in destroying this thing. So I convinced her. We took it. We went, broke it outside in Jesus. When I just broke it, the husband started manifesting. And doing like this, you know, demons, removing things from the wound. And the next day, because a spas came out when I prayed for him, the next day, the wound was healed. Just because they were keeping something in their house, which was demonic. What are the sculptures that are in your house? What is their history? Where did they come from? Do you know where they were made and for what reason? Because some of them can have demons inside that are controlling your poverty. Releasing poverty, releasing sickness, releasing things. So that's why the Bible says, break down sacred pillars. Because maybe where it was made, it is something sacred in that community where you bought it. That's why these souvenirs, when you visit nations, don't just buy things. You go to Thailand, you buy the Buddha. You come, you put it in your lounge, you go there, you just buy things, you put them. Do you know those things? Hello? Some of you buy things that are in line with your totem. I think I taught about that. And you buy even poems of Sokomukanya. You frame them in your house. Those things, they attract demons. Let's also say sacred objects, wooden images, carved images that are demonic must be bent and destroyed. I don't just put sculptures in my house. I want to know who made that sculpture. Why and how did he get the revelation to do that thing? It's very important. Because we are casting out demons, and then some people get shocked, those demons coming back again. Because you have got their object. So demons can argue in the courts of law that we cannot go out because they have our thing. So that's why God is saying those things must be destroyed. When you burn them, when you destroy them, then that demon goes away. It can no longer argue in the spirit.